This is a bit of biology with Mr. Rock. This is evidence for evolution part two. As I stated in the last video, evolution is a theory. However, in science, theory holds a lot of weight. It is an ex scientific explanation that is backed up with evidence, and evolution has a lot of evidence. So in the last video, we talked about the first two, which was homologous, analogous, and vestigial structures. And then we also discussed geographic distribution and how this is evidence for evolution. This video is going to be devoted to the fossil record, direct observation, and genetic similarities. So we're going to be focusing on these last three pieces for this video here. So we're going to start with the fossil record, and this was actually one of the original pieces of evidence for evolution. So with the fossil record, we have observed with skeleton and fossils that with a species, there has been small changes over a long period of time that has developed to new species. And we've seen that with the fossil record. Two of the best examples would be horses and whales. They're the most in-depth fossil record that we have to date. With the whales, believe it or not, the whales actually used to be terrestrial. They're mammals and they used to live on the land. I'm gonna just jump forward here. So the whales used to live on land and they used to look, a lot of people believe it looked something kind of like a dog. And we have observed changes. So we have seen small skeletal changes in the fossil record, one step to another step to another step. And we've seen the skeletal structure get bigger and bigger and bigger. We saw them kind of developing appendages that would make them more suitable for swimming, such as a stronger tail and smaller hind limbs. And a lot of students have a hard time believing this, that whales at one point in time looked like dogs. But you have to take into consideration that this occurred over millions and millions and millions of years. So this just didn't happen over the past 100 years. So it's really hard to think that a whale could have been a dog if you're thinking with too short of a time frame. So fossil record gives evidence for evolution because we're able to observe the small changes that have occurred in a species. Okay, moving on to the fourth piece of evidence. A lot of people say you cannot see evolution happening. It takes too long. In most cases, that is very true, but actually, we have seen evolution take place. The two most obvious ways that we've seen evolution occur is one through antibiotic-resistant bacteria, and then the second one is the famous peppered moth example from the Industrial Revolution. So I'm going to have another video for antibiotic resistance, as that's a really big deal coming up here in our day and age. But this video, I'm going to talk about the peppered moth. So what is the peppered moth? The peppered moth was in England, and what you need to know about it, learning it for the first time, is that there's two different forms. There's a light-colored peppered moth and a dark-colored peppered moth. These peppered moths would hang out on trees, and they would blend into the trees that were like kind of a whitish color. And because of this, the white peppered moth was the most successful in the environment because these moths they would hang out on these trees, and then birds would come by to try to eat them. And like you see here, this is before the Industrial Revolution. The moths would hang out on the trees, and the light colored ones would blend in with the tree better. So they are more camouflaged, and because of that, there were less dark colored peppered moths. However, this thing happened, which was the Industrial Revolution. The reason why this affects the peppered moth is because the soot that was produced in the Industrial Revolution actually covered the trees. As a result, we move over to the second picture here. This is after the Industrial Revolution. The black colored peppered moths actually fit or camouflaged better into their environment. And because of that, the white peppered moth was easily seen. It was eaten more by the birds. They were not able to pass on their genes because they were eaten. And as a result, in just only a few generations, the whole entire population of peppered moth pretty much became dark. So this is the best example of evolution, because evolution is saying the environment changes, species or organisms respond to the change, and you get new different organisms as a response to that environmental change. So the environment change, soot covered the trees, that made the dark colored pepper moss blend in better, and the white ones stuck out, and they're eaten more frequently. So this is a perfect example of evolution happening. So the fossil record was probably the first original piece of evidence for evolution. Now to date, genetic similarities are, it's what every evolutionary biologist uses for evidence of evolution. And this is where we draw some of the strongest conclusions. So what we have here, all of life uses the same genetic language of DNA. We've learned this in DNA. All living organisms have DNA. It's the double helix. Okay, this is a new statement here. The more related organisms, the more related organisms are, the more similar their DNA is. The way you could think about this is something like your cousin and your sister, and if you had an identical twin. If you had an identical twin, you guys would have the exact same DNA. You and your sibling would have about 50% of the same DNA, cousin 25%, and it'd go further and further down. And the exact same true is for evolution. So chimpanzees and humans, these are our closest siblings, relatives. We shared a common ancestor, and we share the most amount of DNA with chimpanzees. It's 98.2% similar. Then further out, gorillas, which is 97.7, and then orangutans, 96.3. And you could do this with all the organisms compared to humans, and we can track our evolutionary history based off of genetic similarities. One thing that this did for genetics is this confirmed our theories based off of the fossil record. So we had some theories initially. We analyzed DNA with a lot of new technology, and it turns out that a lot of our hypotheses that we've made are actually correct because of our DNA analysis. This has been A Bit of Biology with Mr. Ruck. I'm signing off.